If you've stumbled across this video, you have most likely run into this issue. You've loaded into Garry's mod, and you find yourself amongst all these pink and black textures and error models. These are known as missing textures and missing models. It can either be a frustrating issue during your gameplay, or make the game just merely unplayable. Today I'll be showing you how you can fix this issue in the new Windows 11, but this guide can also be replicated in Windows 10. But why does this issue happen in the first place? The reason this problem happens is because Garry's mod is trying to load textures and models which currently don't exist in your game files. Garry's mod is built inside the source engine upon Half-Life 2, and uses assets, which include textures, models, and sounds, from Half-Life 2. However, majority of creators in Garry's mod use assets from Counter-Strike Source when making maps or other workshop content, as there is a larger variety of assets to work from. Since we don't currently have Counter-Strike Source files in Garry's mod, this leads to nothing being able to load, and Garry's mod placing pink and black textures and error models to visually show that something is missing. But how do we fix this? There are three different methods to fixing this issue based on what situation you are in. Two of the methods are the exact same as were shown on my previous guide, which you can view by clicking on the card in the top right of this video by using the link in the description. For this video, I'll just be showing you how to get the Counter-Strike assets and put them into Garry's mod's game files inside Windows 11. Before we start, make sure Garry's mod is not running. The link down in the description will take you to a Google Drive page. Be sure to skip the ads and close all pop-ups that appear. From here, you can download a zipped file which contains the textures and other assets from Counter-Strike Source. The page will tell you that the file is too big to scan for viruses, however there is no need to be afraid as this file purely contains Counter-Strike Source content. Once the zip file has been downloaded, locate it in your downloads folder. Now open Steam, right click on Garry's mod in the games list and select Manage and click Browse Local Files. A folder window will open with Garry's mod's game files. You want to open the window named Garry's mod and then open the folder named Add-ons. Once you've entered the add-ons folder, you need to grab your CSS zip file from your downloads and drag and drop it into your add-ons folder. We're not done yet though, as the CSS files are essentially locked inside the zip file and we need to unzip or extract the files from the folder. Depending on your computer, you might have different icons for the zip file. By default, the icon should look like a zipped folder. However, if you already have a program like WinRAR or similar installed on your computer, it may show with an icon like this. In any case, the process to extract the files is the exact same. Select the folder, right click and choose Extract All. Before you click the next extract button, in the destination path, remove the /css game content so that the last word in the destination path is add-ons. Then you can click extract. The files will then be extracted into the add-ons folder. A new normal folder named css_game_content should now be in your add-ons folder. Try opening the folder to make sure it isn't zipped and make sure it has these five folders inside of it. You can now open Garry's mod, and the textures and models should be able to load in when you load into a map, fixing the missing texture issue. I hope this guide was quick and informative for you. If it did help, please leave a like and consider subscribing to support me. Thanks for watching.